Could the ability to recover from sleep loss be determined by our genes? In 2017, the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine was awarded to three scientists who discovered a group of genes that drive your biological clock.
There are genes such as the clock gene, the period gene, the cryptochrome gene.
But the gene that intrigues neuroscientist Ketema Paul is called BMAL1.
For those of you that know that clocks used to have gears, BMAL1 is the primary gear of the clock.
In his lab at UCLA, Ketema is exploring the role BMAL1 may play in our ability to recover from sleep loss. To do it, he makes use of a classic memory test.
You put a mouse in an environment and present two objects.
In this case, two orange blocks. The mouse spends time getting familiar with them.
After that, we take them out, we sleep deprive them for 6 hours.
While the mouse is kept awake, one of the orange blocks is replaced with a new object, a blue cylinder. After 6 hours, the sleep-deprived mouse is put back in the chamber. Like humans, mice are naturally curious. They're drawn to new things. So a well-rested mouse will spend more time exploring the new object, the blue cylinder. But that doesn't happen with this sleepy mouse.
If you sleep-deprive a mouse and you put it in the same environment, it will spend equal amounts of time between the familiar object and the novel object, because its memory of the familiar object was impaired by the sleep loss.
It seems not to remember the orange block. But what happens if Ketema repeats the memory test with a mouse that has been genetically modified to express higher levels of BMAL1? Will this dialed-up mouse have a better memory, or will the results be the same?
The mouse is now exploring the area in which the novel object is in, another approach to the novel object, and more exploration around the arena, a third approach to the novel object, sniffing, exploring the novel object. So the mouse is clearly spending more time with the novel object, and it suggests that the sleep deprivation did not impair the memory of this mouse, which suggests that overexpressing BMAL1 does make that mouse resilient to sleep loss, and it preserves its memory after sleep deprivation.
But this is not the only surprise, because it turns out BMAL1 works in mysterious ways.
So the B in BMAL1 stands for brain, the M in BMAL1 stands for muscle.
BMAL1 is a gene that's found in the brain and in skeletal muscle, and the resilient mice were ones that had BMAL1 boosted in their muscles, not in their brains.
The result we got was really a surprise. Sleep is a mental process. And that's kind of, as a trained neurobiologist, how I had been looking at it before then.
As Ketema continues his research, he will try to find out how genes in skeletal muscle could influence how we sleep and store memories.
Hopefully, this will lead to more effective therapies for people that are unable to get sufficient sleep and people that need to function in spite of not getting enough sleep.